Good morning, viewers. A very warm welcome on behalf of Team Banjara. And taking us through this program is our program's director, Purnima Ganesh. We call her Purni. So now over to Purni.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. We are live here on FB from Banjara Academy. And for those who have logged in, say maybe India or from around the world, where is Banjara? It is a nice quaint office where everyone works like a family. We are located at Bangalore, India. And at Banjara, we believe a lot into, you know, face-to-face counseling and face-to-face training sessions, face-to-face career and all related activities. However, giving in to the deluge of requests that we have received that we want to continue our learning with Banjara, and we wish that there is some course which is but online, considering the emergencies that have come up due to pandemic, we decided that for the sake of our well-wishers and our students, we bring to you live online courses. And what are they? They are IPCG, which is an international program in counseling and guidance. We have PGDP, which is postgraduate diploma in psychotherapies, and we have CCAD, which is the certificate in child and adolescent development. Each of these programs have a very uniqueness and speciality about themselves, and hence we thought that we will bring it to you purely for the sake of all our well-wishers and all our friends. Banjara is a 40-year-old organization, and we can very happily and proudly say that we have had the opportunity reaching out to more than a million families through counseling, through career counseling, through courses, and you know, through various services that we offer through the academy. And we are also members with full voting rights of the World Federation for Mental Health. So with all these things, what is it that we have for you today? That will come across to you by Dr. Ali Khwaja, who will take you through this whole process of learning. And Dr. Ali, who is a teacher, a mentor, a guide, and a learner himself. He is the chairman and founder of Banjara Academy. Over to Dr. Ali.
Very good morning. If I keep wearing this mask, you can't see my smile. So, what is learning? Go all the way back to the Gurukul days. The best learning has always been experiential learning, isn't it? The guru took charge of the child and gave him a very holistic learning, and that is what produced wonderful people. Even if you go back a century back before technology and all these things came up, the teacher used to be, even if ordinary village teacher used to be a motivator and inspirer. Most of you will recall that in your kindergarten, primary, high school, college, somewhere along the line, your real learning, your inspiration, your motivation came from those few teachers who really inspired you, who were there for you. The moment you would meet that teacher in the morning, you would get this thrill and you would say, hey, this is what I like. This is what I have come here for. That's how it went on. Now, when Banjara Academy came up long, long back, we were very clear that we do not want to start a school or college. We do not want to supplement what is being done very well by hundreds and thousands of institutions. That is academic learning. So what we did was that whatever we are going to train, teach, inspire, motivate, it has to be on an experiential basis, a practical basis. We do not have in any of the courses, textbooks, curriculum, syllabus, examinations, nothing of that sort. Because we want to supplement what is being done by universities and colleges and schools. We do not want to compete with them. That's how our program started, and they flourished. Initially, there was a lot of question mark. Can something like this really sustain? You're going against the tide, no? Who would want to join and pay fees for a course which is not recognized, not affiliated, doesn't get you some proper degree, diploma from some UGC recognized or AICT recognized institutions and all that. We said, fine, those who want to just learn, full stop, they come to us. And they have been coming and they have been coming. Now take a simple thing like learning counseling. We have always believed that counseling can be taught face to face, being there with each other, watching somebody being counseled, doing that counseling by yourself, and then in reviewing, talking to your senior and finding out, did I do the right thing in this particular session? That's how these programs go. And then came the pandemic and a lockdown. Now everybody was locked in at home. So where's the question of having programs, whatever it is, where can people are not stepping out? That is when people started telling us, we have learned so much from Banjara. We want to learn from Banjara. Banjara has so much to teach us. Why don't you start with online courses? We were skeptical. We said, can I really teach online? We questioned ourselves. We started observing others. So many people came on. There was a deluge, as you know, from March, April onwards, of innumerable institutions offering all types of online courses. We kept observing them. We kept analyzing them. We kept learning from them. And then we said, let us make an entry. Let us take some baby steps. So we started off with our free Saturday webinars. Every Saturday, almost, at 11 o'clock, we took up one topic directly connected to human welfare. And we started having a one-hour session and stuff like that. Our third Thursday talks, which were primarily classroom and face-to-face talks, we started beaming them out online so that those who cannot come all the way here and attend that, let them learn. So we started off with that and we started fine-tuning it. We understood what are the shortcomings from the technology point of view, from the communication point of view, from the emotional point of view. How do you connect to people whom you're seeing only on the screen? How to deal with people? If I am talking and there are 20 or 50 people on the other side listening to me, how do I connect to each one of them? In a classroom, over the years, we have developed that knack. I look at one face and I say, hey, this one seems to be a little confused. This one seems to be a little bored. This one seems to be disagreeing with what I'm saying. And I immediately pick up that cue and I take on and make sure that that person learns something in that whole process. Now, how do we do that here? We spent months and months. We were in no hurry as always. We said, if at all we are going to offer online courses, we are going to make sure that not only the students who enroll are going to be happy, but we are going to be happy. At the end of the day, we should be able to say we have done justice because this is totally new. Till few months back, we hardly had any experience of this type of learning process. So we wanted to make sure that the learning is absolutely fine. That's the reason why we took so much time. Every month I have been bombarded with people who kept on saying, why can't you offer some online courses? I'm stuck at home. I'm getting bored. My children are sitting at home. We don't know what to do with ourselves, but we want to learn. We want to grow. We want to evolve. And they kept giving examples of people who are running online courses. I said, okay, let me also learn from them. Let me see what sort of courses, what are they doing? What are the good things that we can, they can be a role model and inspiration to us? What are the shortcomings that we can ensure that we don't get into that? And that is how we said, okay, now we are ready for offering this. As many of you may be knowing, for our counseling course, we stuck to our guns. We said, let it get delayed, it doesn't matter. But we are, those who are in Bangalore, we are going to teach them counseling face-to-face, experientially, practically. So from April, May, we started off postponing. By June, we should have started with our regular course. We said, no, nobody was ready in June to come for a classroom program. We kept postponing. Then we started off with one team, two teams, three teams, four teams, and slowly it evolved. And I'm very happy to tell you that today we have a full quota of DCS 21 batch students who are regularly coming to class, attending, learning so much experientially at a practical level, learning not only from faculty, but learning from each other's experiences, learning from demonstrations, learning from sharing, learning from talking about something, getting choked, not being able to share, and then deciding how to go about it. then watching somebody else and seeing how that person is managing his or her emotions, sharing from the experiences of 18, 20 year old students to 70, 80 year old, much retired senior citizens. Each one brings to the classroom an experiential learning. So now that we are settled with that, everything is fine and we are going smoothly, we said now is the time to launch off the online courses, which we would like to offer to anybody in any part of the country, in fact, any part of the world. So now we have this thing. So our coordinators for each program will quickly in 5 minutes give you an overview on each of these programs, what they mean and what they are. And after that, you can get in touch with us individually by email, by phone, by whatever means, whatever your doubts, questions and stuff like that, we will answer that. What we have done, just in a nutshell, I just wanted to share with you that we have made sure that the online programs are not one way. See, why is it that over the years, the TV was called a idiot box? Why did we say that people who sit and watch TV are couch potatoes? Primarily because it was a one-way communication. No good communication should be one way, right? So we made sure that we are not going to, there are some excellent institutions which are offering various online courses in the form of pre-recorded videos. Now, I went through quite a few of them. I was very curious. I said, how is the learning? Now, when this person is talking and the person is explaining something, I get a doubt in my mind. If I was sitting in a classroom, I would have raised my hand and said, excuse me, boss, I'm not very clear about this. Now, I can't do that. I don't get anything. The screenplay just rolls on and on and on. And in the end, I'm left with my doubts. So we said, even in online courses, we are not going to allow that to happen. There was a lot of temptation that why don't we also record some excellent videos and then start playing them. So anybody wants, they can enroll and they can get on with the things. No, we're not doing that. We do have a few pre-recorded videos in our IPCG program for demonstration, not from the learning point of view, not in the lessons, but as demonstration. So when we say that, how can a counselor be non-judgmental? Just watch a demo. Here is this person talking about something and the counselor is responding. Can you sense and can you feel? And then we point out, see, this is how the counselor behaved. This is how the counselor responded. This is where the counselor evaded interrupting and all that. So the person watches that whole scenario in front of him or her on the screen and learns from that. Those are only the type of recorded videos that we have in our programs. Otherwise, we not only have live sessions, we also have in each of our programs what we call as mentors. So if there are a number of people who are enrolling, we can't have one faculty dealing with 20, 40, 60 people. So we break them into small groups. In fact, in program like IPCG, we do it on a one-to-one basis. Each student has one dedicated mentor whom she can be in touch with on a continuous basis. Either way, the idea of mentoring is, as I said, that the learning should not be one way. We should not thrust something down their throat. So I take a session and I explain some concepts or something of that sort. Let's say you've enrolled for the CCAD program, that is the Certificate in Child and Adolescent Development. You are interested in children, in the welfare. You want to bring up a good generation in whatever role you are playing. You may be a parent, you may be a teacher, you may be a counselor, you may be a social worker, maybe whatever. Just a concerned adult or somebody's uncle, aunt, whatever you are. Now, if you want to understand that, what happens is that a lot of doubts come in your mind. You try it out practically. We have a session and then we say, okay, now go and try it out with any child that you know around your place. So you go, you meet up with the children, you can find out what happens with that particular child. And then you tell your mentor, hey, this is what was told to me, but with this child, I'm not getting that response. What do I do? We can have an interaction on that. We can clear your doubts. We can help you too. And then again, you go back After that, again interact with that child and then come back and say, yeah, this seems to be working. Oh, no, it's working only partially. Let me try a different method. Maybe your mind gets stimulated and you come out with some wonderful ideas and changes and something of that sort. So that is what we are looking at. That just because we many people have to forcibly stay at home and cannot go out and attend any sessions or training or anything of that sort, we respect their wishes. The threat of COVID is definitely not gone, and we have no idea when it will go away. So there's no point in just sitting and hoping and waiting that, yeah, you know, this vaccine is coming, this is happening, that is happening. Let life move on is what I believe in. Yes, COVID has put a certain amount of restrictions on us, but it should not, it can only restrict us physically, right? It cannot restrict us mentally. These are some of the lessons that I have, learned. For example, I always quote that very famous book called Man's Search for Meaning, written by a psychiatrist called Viktor Frankl. Viktor Frankl was put in the concentration camp of the Nazis, the Germans, in Second World War. He went through the worst of physical torture. But when he kept his mind alive, when he could do visualization that after the war is over and I'm released, I'll go back home and I'll enjoy reading this book. I'll have a warm fireplace. I'll have my pet dog sitting next to me. I'll be having a hot cup of coffee. His mind was not constrained by the powerful Nazis. And that is why he survived the concentration camp. These are the type of examples which always inspire me to understand that your mind should never be constrained. And all that we are doing, any of our programs, any learning that we are trying to impart, takes into account the fact that COVID or no COVID, lockdown or no lockdown, pandemic or no pandemic, your mind should be free. Not too many people remember and quote the great saying of Guruji Rabindranath Tagore, where the mind is without free, into that let my country awake. Our country is already woken up 73 years back. Let our minds also be awake. Let our minds not be constrained in slavery to any pandemic, any corona, or anything of that sort. So, respecting that there are quite a few people out there who have restrictions. They may have small children that they are worried about. They may have very old, you know, family members, and they feel that if we go out, we may bring back the virus, and if we give it to somebody who is very old and who has what we call as comorbidities, that means the person is already suffering from anything, diabetes, hypertension, heart problems, whatever it may be. Those people are definitely more vulnerable to getting an infection of any form. So why should I, you know, be the carrier? Why should I even take that 1% risk when I go out and I come back, I may bring the virus and pass it on to somebody who may not be able to withstand it, and the person may have extreme difficulties, even leading to death or whatever it is. So respecting the wishes of such a few who feel that this is the time has not come, it is not ripe to step out. At the same time, saying that life will not be put on hold because of any pandemic. Life will go on. And the only way life becomes meaningful is if learning goes on. Your growth is directly dependent on your learning. The day your learning stops, you have become old. You better declare yourself a senior citizen and sit at home. On the other hand, it is such a pleasure to see people who retire from very, very happy and fulfilling careers, 30 years, 40 years, and they come back and say, can I join your program and become a counselor or take care of children or whatever the things that you are offering to me? Such a pleasure. Those people are still growing. In fact, you must even keep your inner child alive. If you are not childlike, if you have taken life too seriously, if you can only think of corona, today, how many people got infected in Bangalore, how many in Karnataka, how many in India, how many in the whole world, out of that, how many recovered, how many died. These are just pure statistics. It makes absolutely no difference to my life. If I am going to be hit with corona, so be it. If I'm going to die by corona, so be it. But till then, I'm going to live life fully. Of course, taking precautions, as I said, if I feel that I should not go out because of the restrictions for my child or my parent or whatever, we'll do that. We will take all those precautions. But the mind has to be free. The mind should say, regardless, what could have been a worse restriction than being put in a concentration camp of the Nazis? Just read about it. You know, you will become shocked. You will not be able to believe if they describe to you how these prisoners were treated. And yet there were people like Viktor Frankl and so many others who withstood and emerged triumphant. Each one of us can do that today with this Nazi called Corona or COVID-19 or whatever name you want to call it. Let the oppressors come. Take an example from our freedom fighters. At that time, Great Britain, the empire on whom the sun never sets on the British Empire, they used to say, they were global. What power they had. And when people like Gandhiji or so many unnamed freedom fighters, when they stood up in protest and said, we are not going to take this. Today we live in a free country because of them. Can we do the same thing today? Can we say that we are not going to get bogged down by this? Life will continue. We will continue to have those little joys of life. We will continue bonding with our family members. We will keep giving a good future to our children, whoever they may be. We will take care of the younger generation. We will reach out in so many different ways. We will pick up psychotherapies. We will do whatever has to be done. We will take up learning, which is going to make life more enriched. And that is why our slogan is enriching life through empowerment. Our goal is to empower you. Make your goal into empowering yourself and thereby empowering all those over whom you have an influence or those whom you love and care for. That is how this whole process goes. After going through so many weeks and months of questioning, re-questioning, aligning, realigning, developing, sharpening, revising, etc., we are now ready to launch off, starting with our programs in the month of November. We are going to be offering you these very nice, experiential, interactive online programs. And as I said, my colleagues will give you the basics of what these are. After that, we will keep sufficient time for you to ask questions. So we will divide the questions into two parts, those which are specific about the programs. Like somebody has just typed in, what's the difference between PG, DPA and IPC, that sort of thing. So we will answer those specific things. And then I will be back after my colleagues have given you this presentation and have answered your specific questions. I would love to spend time with you before we close today's webinar on answering any and every question. There is no such thing as a stupid question. Maybe I'll give you some stupid answers. Please bear with me. But you can be reassured that whenever I speak, I'll speak from the heart and I'll tell you the truth. Congruence is the greatest quality that a human being can have. Let us all stick to that. And let me pass you back to the coordinator who will take you through each of our programs.
Thank you.
with you again. What we are going to be doing is, at Banjara, we work as a family and as a team. For everything, you know, each one is involved, and we do a lot of brainstorming back and forth, and then we come to something which we know is ready for our students. So that's how we usually proceed. So what we are going to be doing today is, I will take you through one of the courses which is called International Program in Counseling and Guidance. Then my two other colleagues, Lakshmi and Chandra, Dr. Lakshmi and Dr. Chandra, will be taking you through PGDP. And then Sonal, who is the director of Gurukuls, what is Gurukuls? We'll let you know in a short while when Sonal comes across. She will take you through the whole course of CCAD, which is Certificate in Child and Adolescent Development, PGDP, which is Post-Graduation Diploma in Psychotherapies, and IPCG, which is International Program in Counseling and Guidance. Each course is very different, unique in its own right, and it depends on what is your purpose to be doing this course. And I will also introduce you to our students coordinator for all these courses, who is Seema. And if any one of you calls up, you will be interacting with Seema. She will take you through the whole course. She will also try and find out what is the purpose for which you are doing the course, and if our course meets the purpose. If for any reason we feel that it may not meet your purpose, we will caution you also. So because we want you to get in with an informed decision, that is our very earnest effort whenever we tell people about the courses that are available for us. So moving on to IPCG, International Program in Counseling and Guidance. How this whole thing started was, Banjara has a course which is a classroom course called DCS, Diploma in Counseling Skills. So we have students from different walks of life, right from 17 to 70, 80, 84 years of age, and some are doctors and lawyers and engineers, IT professionals, or golfers, or businessmen, entrepreneurs. And all these different people have one mission in common, which is to reach out to self and to others at an emotional level. And that was kind of, you know, a classroom course. So we do have students who come down from different states, come attend the weekend course and then go back. That also has happened. However, since the word started spreading, there were many students pan world actually who asked us that, why don't you give us a course? At least we will be able to understand the nuances of the different ages, different stages, and counseling per se. That's where this course came into being. And as far as the classroom course is concerned, we have 22 batches, which is already for the last 22 years our courses are on. So on those similar lines, and keeping in mind that we need to make it as introspective, as practical, as experiential as possible, we have made our efforts to make this course, one, it is a totally self-paced program. What I mean by self-paced program, it is a 12-month course, and you could choose that, okay, maybe the first two courses, I may just, speeden up with it. The fifth and sixth one seems to be a little more, which is close to my heart, so I might as well give it a little more time. Pour into it some more, think about it some more, and only then get into the course. So that's why we call it a self-paced program. In IPCG, which you can say is the, in a way, the online version of DCS, the classroom course. So anyone who is out of the city also of Bangalore in India can also go ahead and understand the nuances of counseling. So what happens in this course is, one, as I mentioned, it is a self-paced program. You have 12 modules. In these 12 modules, we give you a quick overview of, how the counseling, history of counseling, how it has got introduced, and how did we feel the need of counseling, and in the last two decades, how counseling has really geared up. And of course, the writing on the wall is so clear that counseling, reaching out emotionally, understanding people, understanding ourselves, is going to be a much needed service in this world. So keeping that in view, we have designed all of our courses. So this course, as I mentioned, one, self-paced. Second, it's a 12-module program, and it has a mentoring system. Now you will have a one-to-one mentoring system with, you know, a mentor who we choose, keeping in view that, you know, from which place you are, which language is suitable for you, what is your background, so that you can have a much better connect with your mentor. So that is a mentoring system. Could also, it's not just pick up some and, you know, give it off to someone. We ensure that it suits you better for you to be comfortable and learn the skills. If you are in better hand with a good mentor and if your connect is better, the feel is different, right? So that's what we do. Now your mentor will take you through the course, will help you to, you know, assess your assignments which you will be doing through the course. In case you feel that, you know, you have any kind of a personal issues which you would like to discuss it with someone who is very neutral, non-judgmental, and still understands your point of view, that whatever you have done is appropriate, you can do that with your mentor. So your counseling sessions also can happen with your mentor. In the past, we have had students from pan world who have done this course, and so many of them are also doing very meaningful work having done this course. So we have this time over revamped the whole course, refurnished the whole course, making it as practical, you know, with a new type of experiences. As Dr. Ali mentioned, that you will have videos where hands-on, you will actually see the video and understand, oh yeah, I think this person was curious. Oh, I never realized that this was a curiosity question. I never realized that, was I so judgmental? Yes, I know. I think I can, you know, learn from watching these sessions. So we will also be giving you video sessions. We'll be giving you audio sessions. We will be giving you a lot of, yes, that course is a little, you need to read, you know, theory, of course, because it is online. So you'll have to bear with us. Anytime that you come to Bangalore, having done this course, you can come down, meet us. We have had students who have done this course, come down to Bangalore and still done meaningful work. So that is about IPCG, the International Program in Counseling and Guidance, which is a self-paced one-year program. We don't need any prerequisites for this. Yes, for all our courses, one major, and we are very, very particular about that requirement, is that you need to have a heart to reach out to people. If you have that kind of a thought process, you are absolutely welcome to this large Banjara family. And with this, now I will hand over the session to Dr. Lakshmi and to Dr. Chandra, who will take you through the PGDP program. Thank you.
Hi, everybody. Hello. Let me quickly introduce you to what you will come across in the PGDP course. So this is the postgraduate diploma in psychotherapies. So what you will learn here in this course is the reason behind why we do the various things we do in a counseling process. If you have already done DCS or any other counseling course, you would have learned some things like how you should sit, how you should respond to some things, how you should make eye contact, and all those things, right? So here you will understand why you will be doing all that. So you will understand, you will learn about the various approaches to counseling. You will also learn about the different psychotherapeutic approaches. We will not go into all the detailed skills and the actual counseling sessions of CBT or REBT, but you will get an overview of the many different psychotherapies. This would be a good platform for you to understand the many different approaches, and then you can always choose to specialize in one or more of them. For doing this, as Ali had mentioned, we will not follow a very strict textbook-based approach where each class you will be given, you will be given a chapter, we will explain the chapter to you, and then you will be given questions and you have to answer them. You know, that kind of an approach we will not be following. We here have a very different methodology where you will be your own subject of study. Why not? You are human and we are studying human behavior. So whatever aspect of human behavior we are studying, I think you can observe yourself much more clearly than you can observe anybody else, right? So, and you can have a greater depth of understanding of any concept that we are talking about when you apply it to yourself. So, you will apply any theory that you learn to yourself to understand the theory better. So, you will work to be an even better version of you. Why is that important? Why are we working so much on you when we are saying that we are talking about counseling? Counseling is a very human process. It is not like, oh, you have a headache, okay, I'll prescribe this medicine. You have throat pain, I'll prescribe that medicine. It is not a process of diagnosis and prescription. In the counseling process, there is a very emotional interaction between two humans. So it is very important for you to be in a place where you are in a position to give that emotional support that the other person is reaching out for. So that is why you will work to be an even better version of you. As you are going through this course, you will learn about personality, you will learn about the various theories of personality, and you will apply them to yourself, and you will yourself work out which is the best theory that suits you, that suits your personality. And then you will work on yourself to understand the theory better, and you will work with the theory to understand yourself better. That is what we will try to achieve during this course. Lakshmi, would you like to add something?
Yeah, so I think Dr. Chandra has practically covered most of the thing. It is about the how and the why. So the counseling skills as such are what you will be doing. And here in PGDP, through the help of the theoretical frameworks, which have also been set up with practice and experience only. The theory has come from experience, and experience is going to be increased and enhanced with the theory. So mostly we will be talking about the how and the why. And so how it works, why it works, which is very important to know, because like we are going to be practically covering the, you know, dealing with the self processes, which is the key in any counseling process, in any human interaction. So the core is the self, and all of this will converge into the processes of the self. So this course, we will be dealing with the concept and their processes. So if whatever concept we take up, be it listening, or be it empathy, or be it any other self-awareness or emotional intelligence or emotional awareness, first of all of this, the concept and the process of it, and the process, like Dr. Chandra has said, is through some kind of reflection on our own selves. So what is happening within us, and how we can actually be an instrument. So in a counseling interaction, it is through you are the instrument. One person is the instrument through which the change is affected, or some kind of change is brought about in the other. And that is very important. So this whole course is it's put together in such a way that it is a process-based, experiential-based program through the theoretical, the mainstream, and other theoretical frameworks that are out there in in psychology and in counseling and in personality. So this is how I would put it across, the how and the why and the process and the concept through which through yourself you will enhance yourself as well as affect change in the other. Yeah, Chandra, Dr. Chandra.
Thank you, Lakshmi. I think we have pretty much covered everything. Back to you, Purnima.
We have had a very popular program, which is a certificate in child and adolescent development. And the specialty of this was so much liked by our students and by the word that spread across to the others, that again, as Ali mentioned, that we do have our care and concern and respect for those who are not able to move out, but then they want to understand their children better. They want to understand their adolescents better. And how does this whole program take place? That we have put in all into a nice, concise, capsuled program called Certificate in Child and Adolescent Development, taking you through the nuances and also details of this program is Sonal Patel, who is the director of Banjara's Gurukul, a very unconventional learning center. Over to Sonal.
Hello everyone. It's great to see you in this present situation of pandemic also. You are all, all enthusiastic to learn and keep your learning going on. Congratulations for you, to you for all that. Okay, regarding certificate in child and adolescent development, I would like to tell you that first thing is, why do we need to do this kind of a program where we are going to learn only about children? This course will cover only about understanding children right from the stage of pregnancy till technically I would say 18 years, right? So how each stage has its own importance of development and how a child grows into a human being, a quality human being, I would say, where there is meaningful work done by that person. Now, if you want to ask a question like, why should I do where it's only related to children? Like, we are always looking for something better for tomorrow. We want something which is always better than today for tomorrow. And children are our tomorrow. They are going to be tomorrow's grown-up citizens. And if we are doing something which is going to give them a better tomorrow, we are investing in what we are looking for ourselves. That will be our selfish reason to understand children. Where do we understand children? Now, children are all over the world, everywhere around, where we find there's something to learn from them. A lot of learning happens through observation. A lot of learning happens through interaction. And if you are equipped with certain things that you can observe, and how do you observe, is something we will teach in Certificate in Child and Adolescent Development. When it comes to, if I don't have a child, means I don't have a child, but still I like to work with children or I like to understand children, even then you can, you don't need to own a child to understand a child. Because this world is filled of children. When you observe and spend time with a child, it helps you to understand that child, where the child stands in the developmental process, and how do you help the child at that particular stage to enhance his development. That is what will be taken covered in Certificate in Child and Adolescent Development. And when we say that, okay, if I have understood the child, how is it going to help me or how is it going to help in my family? When a child is understood, a lot of Harmony is developed within the family. And when there's harmony, you know there's good mental health around. So it's like linked one to the other. And it really helps in bringing an harmonious relationship within the family and around you, and enhance each person in the family, that learning process to go on in a very harmonious way. So that's one more reason I would say that understanding children is like equally important. Now, what is covered in child and adolescent development is the importance of the five main domains of development, which is physical, emotional, social, cognitive, language. All the five are equally important. Most of the time we take care of the physical development because that is seen. Language development is heard, so we also work towards that language development. What is unseen is the cognitive development. The emotional development, at some point it is seen, but we don't know how to deal with it. So that also is covered majorly because we in Banjara believe in emotions the most. And when there is a heart to learn, everything is easy to go ahead and, you know, grasp. And you all, as I understand, attending this webinar today, where, you know, your learning is going on. So such kind of people are something are going to really gain from certificate in child and adolescents, where you are going to give a good step for our citizens tomorrow. Any questions that you have regarding the course, you can please question me.
Okay, guys, you see sitting with me, he's Sunita. Sunita is telling you hi. Sunita will be coordinating the course. That is, for these online courses, we need a lot of, you know, interaction with the students, though online, of course, but then the sending of the mails, receiving of the mails, sending of the mails to the assessor, getting it back in case somebody is a little ill, not feeling up to it. You know, that complete, there's a lot of coordination, and we want to give even our online courses a heart to the whole course. That is our main purpose, and we are very, very sure about this. And Sunita is the one who will be coordinating this from the course point of view. And now I will be taking you on and introducing you to Seema, who will be coordinating our questions, which are, you know, asked by a few of you all. Lakshmi is here, Chandra will be joining us, Sonal is here. We are all here. Whatever questions you have, ask us. And that Seema, who just wore her spectacles, so you don't get confused. So we have Seema and Sonal on the frame here. And Seema is our students' coordinator. What we want you to do is that every course, whichever, you know, that anyone wants to take, that is, for example, IPCG, which is an online course about counseling, which takes you through the ages and stages, understanding children, understanding people, understanding elderly, understanding marriage, understanding loneliness, fear, anger, addiction. All these things are on one side, and understanding children till they are adolescents, right from the pregnancy stage, will be through Sonal, and understanding all the psychotherapies, as Chandra and Lakshmi just mentioned to you. All these questions, you know, whatever comes to your mind, we are all ready to reply. And yeah, Seema is the person who will be doing the complete students coordination. So you could please feel free to write to her, to speak to her, have a WhatsApp video, audio, whatever suits you fine, so that you can get in, make a decision with all information, with the long-term purpose for which you are doing this course. So, yeah, we are all here. Our team is here. And in case you have any specific questions with regard to any particular course, please feel free to ask us, and maybe Seema will also help us to coordinate this.
Right. So I start with Bharati. Bharati is asking, what course is most appropriate course after DPCS? So after the counseling course, what is the most appropriate?
Yeah, I would like to answer this. What we need to do is, we need to find out what is your long-term purpose. Do you want to work in any niche areas, or do you think that you would want to, you know, amass the knowledge of psychotherapies, which will really help you in the purpose for which you are reaching out? So what you could do is, because this is very, very specific to your requirement, we would want to answer this specially to you, and you are a part of our academy and our big family. Please feel free to call up Ali or me. We can help you understand your career plan and then immediately make a decision of what is going to suit you the best. Okay, so each course is very unique in its own might and it should serve your purpose. Okay, thank you.
Right, Purni, the next one also for you. Is IPCG a total online course or do we have to attend contact classes?
Yeah, as of now, it's a complete online course. And if for any reason we can, you know, get something which is maybe later, the course is devised to be made online, okay? But then if there are enough students who show interest and say that, no, we would like to come to the academy, if, you know, you have the opportunity of coming to Bangalore, attending, we will be more than happy to have a specialized, experiential workshop for you all. But by far, it is meant to be online. But we are also open to give you experiential workshops.
Right. So the next question, I think, is not just for IPCG, but I think all the courses. Does IPCG have any evaluation criteria when the course is completed based on which the certificate is given? Clear some exam or some sort of certain score?
So yeah, I think exam. Yes, exams. I just love the word. Whenever we talk of exams, unit tests, reading, syllabus, portions, doesn't it give you the jitters? Right from our, oh my God, he has not written A or not written B. Right from those days onwards, we are all bogged down with exams and syllabus. And all our courses, even a course like PGDP, which is on psychotherapies, Chandra and Lakshmi have devised it in such a wonderful fashion that you need not be bogged down with any kind of exams or any kind of tests. But yes, we do have our evaluation method. Each one of us has our evaluation methods. We will be giving you assignments from time to time, which nothing is right or wrong. It is a point of view. Your mentors will sit down, discuss with it, and ultimately at the end of it, you need to understand what that course is about, all about. That is what we want you to do. It could be in your own words. It could be with your own thought processes. Am I right, Lakshmi and Chandra? And even Sonal.
Yeah.
You will have assignments, you will have mentoring sessions, everything. But then it's not with grades or marks, because marks scare us. And grades make us feel that there is a divide. I'm better or I'm worse off. And we don't want you to do anything like that. We want you to enjoy the process of learning.
Right. So now this is for Lakshmi and Chandra. Rinalini is asking, can a person like me who doesn't have a background in counseling but is keen on reaching out to people and become a better version of myself take up the psychotherapy course?
Lakshmi, yeah, would you like to answer? We have a provision about that those who do not have an introduction into counseling. If you do want to do this course, we can give you a kind of a bridge, a few sessions where you will understand the processes of counseling, and then you can, join in into this. You can be added to this program. So you can do this side by side also, in fact. The counseling and the PGDP, both, which will also be quite of good value, I would say. If you do both together, also is a good way of learning the both the counseling processes and enhanced way of being yourself. Chandra, you would want to add something?
I think you have given the clarity. We can carry on.
Right. Another question, Chandra. Right. Will the PGDP, is the PGDP good enough to work as a counselor, or any other specialization can be done post completion?
I believe if you have learned the skills in a course like DCS, and then you deepen your understanding with PGDP, I think you are, I think you should be able to work as a counselor. Of course, you can always enhance your knowledge by doing other courses. That is a lifelong learning process. You don't need to stop learning. But I think with these two courses, you should be able to handle. Yes,
and well said, Sandra. So what we will also now be doing is that there are quite a few questions which may, you know, possibly need many more replies. So what we will be doing is that we have given you our email IDs, our telephone numbers, and we will be more than happy to be answering these questions in person. And for now, taking you forward on this conversation and this FB Live is Dr. Ali coming up again. What we will be doing is that we would want Dr. Ali to continue with the process of how learning through online courses, how we can make it as effective, and what is our honest effort. And I would like Dr. Ali to take this conversation and this talk forward.
I really don't want to boast, but we have inculcated in us the culture in Banjara of what we call as the Gurukul system. The intention of a Gurukul should be that the overall well-being, learning, growth, evolution of the learner should take place, right? So what we do is, on an individual basis, I've just been listening to all the various questions that have been coming up. We would like to tailor make certain situations, certain courses, certain programs for you. So like Purnima was telling you just now, get in touch with us if you have these type of doubts. Should I take this course or that? If I'm not done this, can I do that? That's a very individualistic thing. And we would love to guide you on that. Including, there are times when we tell people who are willing to enroll for a particular course and we tell them this is not suitable for you. We would not like you to waste your time, energy and money doing this, because at this juncture of your life or without this or with this, this may not be the most suitable thing for you to do. Very often we have guided people to go and do outside some other courses which may be more appropriate for them. So that is the type of attitude that we have always had, and we will continue to have that. We are not a commercial organization. We are not trying to sell these courses to you. Numbers just do not matter to us. Instead of having 100 mediocre students, if we have 10 very committed and very enthusiastic students, it is a joy to spend time with those 10, learn from them while we teach. That is what our attitude has been. So any of these type of questions, like, can the academy arrange online interactive sessions with other students who have joined the IPCG course at least once or twice during that film? Yeah, these are all very good suggestions, and we will take that up whenever you need, whenever we have this thing. We are also planning that once in a month or so, those who are doing IPCG, we'll get them all on one platform and have a sharing or interaction or whatever it is. All these things, we are always open to it, and we have been doing it. Somebody had asked about contact classes. Whenever there has been a demand, even if there are 5 or 7 students who say that, can we come to Bangalore and learn a few things or see how counseling is done in the academy and all that, we have organized 3-day workshops which we call ECW. They come here. If necessary, we even help them to find the proper place to stay right here. And then spend those 3 days fruitfully enjoying, looking at things, learning that, and go back. And that bonds you further from us. But that is not a precondition. Those who cannot come, we will never force them to come. That is how we are flexible at every stage of whatever I'm doing. Sanat says that I'm studying in class 11 and I've taken psychology. I'm exploring more options for further studies. Can I enroll for one of these courses now? Yes, definitely. But we'd again like to talk to you and find out, what is your level of comprehension, your level of understanding of life, what have been your experiences. See, an 11th standard student can be as mature as a 40-year-old if he or she has gone through certain experiences of life and has that broader outlook to life. Sometimes we've also had students who feel that we feel that's too early. So let them learn a little more now that you've come in the world of psychology. Spend one or two more years reading up the theory and getting a stronger foundation. Then you'll be ready to come into the practical world. So that's how we can discuss with each one of these people. In case I'm not able to come for any reasons to the center, will it be absolutely okay? Indra, that is the whole idea, that none of you at any time will be forced to come even once to the center. Everything can be done at home. And that is one of the reasons why we took so much time to organize all this, so that we have streamlined everything right from the enrollment procedure to the end of the program, and the certificate will be sent to you, the hard copy, soft copy, everything, you know, will be done. And you can be rest assured, because like I mentioned in the beginning, we do not know how long this, you know, pandemic is going to last. So we are not going to hold up. For all you know, by the time you complete your course, if still you're not confident enough to step out, we will respect that. And we'll ensure that your learning goes on even without stepping out of your house. What next?
Yes, Shantel is asking, Ali, can the academy arrange online interactive sessions with other students who have joined IPCG online course?
I just answered that.
Oh, is it okay?
I answered that. We are definitely planning to do that. Once in a month or two, we'll have some sort of webinar where people can come on and they can share their experiences and things. We've always been doing that. We encourage people who have learned, and when they are practicing, what they have learned and what they are practicing and things of that sort. Details about Gurukul, Divya, we will send it to you. And whatever, if you want any benefit from Gurukul, we'll definitely work on that.
Right, Ali. Difference between DCS and PGDP?
DCS does not go into the therapies. You know that, what is psychotherapy? Psych is the mind and therapy is the healing. Okay. But basically, you have to understand human beings, you have to understand emotions, you have to understand relationships, and then you have to sharpen certain skills in order to be a counselor. What are they? To be able to build rapport, make a counselee comfortable, a stranger. To be able to be a good listener. To be able to be non-judgmental, accepting people as is, where is, regardless of whether they have committed the worst crime on earth. To be able to empathize, put yourself in the other person's shoes and think not what he is saying or doing, but why he is saying or doing certain things. Giving positive strokes, having patience, in ability to paraphrase, summarize, ask very relevant, open-ended questions. All these skills are taught in the DCS program. Now in PGDP, we will be doing two things. One is to give you a bird's eye view of all the outstanding and popular psychotherapies of the world. You know that it all started with Sigmund Freud, who came out with psychoanalysis, and it went on to so many other therapies. Many of them have their own individual merits and individual advantages. So even before you decide to go deeper into a particular psychotherapy or become a practitioner, we'd like you to have a overview of all the possible therapies and what each one of them means and which would suit you better. Parallel to that, Lakshmi and Chandra will also take you through a process of understanding yourself, building yourself up, connecting to the world, which is also part of psychotherapy. For example, if you have read the book of Carl Rogers, which says becoming a fully functional person. So when you become a fully functional person, when you can look inward and evolve and grow, you know which are the psychotherapies, which to use at what time. You may even learn more than one, and you should be able to know which is applicable where. So that is what the PGDP program, that is the postgraduate diploma in psychotherapies, takes you into. That is the subtle difference. Yeah.
Right, Ali. This was answered. Any prerequisites for any of the courses?
Yes, we have a very, very strong prerequisite. We are very strict about it. The prerequisite is that you must be a caring, compassionate, human being, and at the same time, you should be totally open to learning. If you have a fixed mind, see, normally many universities and institutions, they say, no, that you must have studied up to this level, you should have this qualification, you should have 16 years of study, you should have this and that. Frankly, between you and me, I always enjoy those who have less education. If any of you have dropped out from third standard, seventh standard, I will wholeheartedly welcome you, because you are, you know, open more to learning than some of the people who think that just because I've studied higher or greater or performed or whatever it is, I'm the same. But doesn't matter whether you have studied just the bare minimum, whether you, the only requisite, of course, is to know functional English. That's the only thing that, you know, would be a prerequisite. But primarily, you should be open. These are the two things that you must keep in mind, that you must be open to what is referred to as learning, unlearning, and relearning. That is how the real growth takes place.
Right, Ali. Garima is asking, is there any materials to be read while related to CCAD program?
Yes. We will study material, Garima, but relax. The material will not be more than 1 or 2 pages per topic. We want to convey certain things. We want you also to have that material ready for a ready reckoner. 1 month later, 1 year later, you may have some doubts about something particular. So you should have it with you, right? So we will be sending you the material. But every week, your involvement from the point of view of reading up will be, how long does it take to read one page? Maybe 3, 4, 5, 6 minutes, even if you go very slow. So I can assure you that that is the time commitment that is needed. Whenever you are free, you can even load it on your phone when you are traveling, when you are sitting waiting for somebody, when you are not doing anything else. You can read through it and you can ask yourself certain questions, and you can ask the same questions later on to your mentors, things like that.
I was just thinking that if Garima can put in her Gmail ID, we can immediately at least send her the prospectus.
That's so right. Go ahead, Garima. Put up your email ID. We'll send you the prospectus.
Right, Ali. Can 2 courses be taken simultaneously, like the IPCG and the PGDP?
Why not? Yes. There's no restriction, because just as I was telling Garima just now, since there's no theory, there's no lot of learning, or you don't have assignments which you have to sit for hours and hours going and reading or exploring and finding out the theory and all that. Even when we give you an assignment, no, it is very, very practical. It is experiential. When you are dealing with a child of this is age and this is the behavior, how would you actually deal with the child? We will not ask you, do you know about Piaget's theory and so's this thing and so syndromes and so therapies and this and that. The assignment will not ask you to do anything which requires research, reading up, and of course, cutting and pasting from the internet, which is the most common thing which a lot of students do when they have to do assignments. We will make sure that you don't have to do anything like that.
Right, Ali. Anupama is asking, is it possible to learn a therapy in detail?
Yes, it is. But I would also like to tell you that if you have gone through the psychotherapist program, that is PGDP, we are making it very clear that we are not certifying you as a therapist in any of those. We have given you an exposure. We have given you an understanding. Now, some people want to use that to be able to refer to the correct person. So when you are counseling, you say, I can understand that this counselee needs more of REBT, rational emotive behavior therapy. This person needs more of transactional analysis. This person needs more of person-centered therapy. And you can either refer to an expert or you can start learning. We will guide you and help you how to go about becoming really proficient in any of these therapies and this and that, how to go deeper, how to continue with your learning. But before that, we'd like you to run through the whole program so that you are very clear about what you want to do. Otherwise, you know how it is. No? Students are pushed into science, commerce, arts without knowing where they are headed. And then years later, they question, have I landed up? We don't want that to happen to you through your life as a therapist, as a counselor, as a teacher, as a concerned adult, whatever you are. We'd like you to go step by step. And that is one of the ideas why we have this PGDP program. And not just you know, a CBT program or an REBT program or Gestalt program and all that. We don't want to narrow you down to that. We want you to get an overview and then let us know if you want to pick up any of those therapies, how to go about it, we'll guide you.
Right, Ali, although you have kind of answered this, but can IPCG be considered as a substitute to DCS?
Can I be very frank with you? No. The answer is no. We run the IPCG program primarily, in fact, well, up till last year, we were very, very strict that anybody who resides in and around Bangalore city cannot enroll for IPCG because however far we have people coming from Banshankari and HSR layout and all sorts of places, we have people coming from Tumkur and Hubli and Mysore also. The idea was that this cannot be a substitute to that. But there was always this question from people that I do not live in Bangalore. I live very far away. And I'm very keen to learn the practical aspects of counseling. Yes, I can enroll in an open university and in 2 years, I can even get a master's degree in counseling psychology and all that. But will I get that experiential learning? I will not. So that's why we started IPCG as a means to help those people. So if you're doing IPCG, it will be your responsibility to get more and more of practical exposure. And that's one of the reasons why we appoint an individual mentor with whom you connect on a one-to-one basis. Now, you will be telling that mentor that I went to such and such school or such and such office or such and such place, or I just counseled my neighbor who was going through an emotional disturbance. This is what I did. And then the mentor will help you and guide you. No, I think you should sharpen this. No, I think you should restrain yourself from doing that, or you should reach out more in this area and all that. That is how the substitution takes place.
Right, Ali. Rupali is asking, after completing the course, can we still reach out to our mentors?
Absolutely, absolutely. Some of the students have formed a sort of, you know, lifelong bonding with the mentor. But of course, it primarily depends. It's not compulsory that the mentor, you know, the mentor may not like you. You may like the mentor. But as a person who is learning human behavior and relationships, if you can impress your mentor that, see, I've really learned from you, I have that gratitude for you, I will respect your privacy and your time, but I would like to be connected to you. There are so many instances where the mentor and the mentee have formed almost like a lifetime relationship.
Ali, there was a question earlier about Gurukul. Can you briefly talk about Gurukul also?
Yeah. See, as I told you, Banjara has always gone against the tide. We have tried to fill in the gaps in the education system. So why we started this Gurukul was to understand that there are a lot of children who cannot or do not want to go to regular schools. There may be children who have school refusal. They were angry with something. They were, you know, very irritated. They just don't want to go to school. There are children who cannot cope up with the thing. They are slow learners. They are intellectually challenged. They cannot face and sit in a class of 40, and when the teacher is going at her own pace, they cannot keep up, and that's why they get scolded and they get punished and things like that. Then there are children who are going through some sort of developmental disabilities. These are things like autism, cerebral palsy, what we refer to as spastics, Down syndrome, any of these type of things. Those children also need a lot of hand-holding and personalized attention. So what we do is, when a child comes to Gurukul, we do the assessment, not only of the child, but the parents also, because we need to know how far the parents are open, what they have done so far, what they are willing to do with their child. And then some of the children we straight away guide and say, in your locality, in your area, there is such and such special school, or there's this integrated school, or with a little bit of boost, your child can go back to mainstream schooling and we will give the backup. Some children stay back for some time and they continue to get inputs and learning from Gurukul with the idea that they are not yet ready to go back into mainstream school. So we will do some more handholding for a few weeks, few months, as and when necessary. And whenever we find that the child is ready to move on, the child moves on. And of course, then there are children who are so severely challenged that they cannot go back to the mainstream schooling. Those are the children we encourage to see whether they can do at least that, what is known as the A level, B level, C level of the NIOS, that is equivalent to third standard, fifth standard, and seventh standard. At least let them have that satisfaction of having, you know, got a certificate from Government of India that they have cleared these sort of things and how to go about it. All these things are done at the this thing. They've also very successfully started 2 months back a program called Unschool, which the details I think Sonal must have already given you. You can get in touch for more details on that.
Right, I mean, people are also asking about our life skills program. Mm-hmm. So the next slide.
We have just concluded the life skills program. Because this program is a train the trainer program, we insist that it should be a, you know, classroom program. So for years and years, we have been doing the classroom program. This year, what happened was, again, because of the limitations of that, there were a few students who said, I want to continue. I want to do this life skills program. But these are my limitations. I cannot come to the classroom. So this was the first time that we made it choice-based. We had a number of students who were coming to the classroom and attending. We had a few students who were online. So we would put on our laptop. They would also be able to watch the proceedings of the class, interact, give their this thing. And in fact, again, what we were doing was one mentor would then take over for half an hour after the class is over and check out with each of these few who were not coming and who are only attending the online program. What have you learned? What have you done? How are you preparing for your presentations? And take a demo and that sort of thing. So with that, this was the first time that we did it. Now that we have completed it and we are starting other programs, we will bide our time for a little while. We will wait and see. If we feel that the situation is really improving and people can come, that would be ideal. We will start the next batch, which will be a face-to-face classroom program. If this thing is extending indefinitely and people are still not safe enough to step out and all that, after we've settled down with these 2-3 programs that we are talking about today, a few months from now, we will start another program where we will give the choice to you if you want to do it online, the life skills program.
In fact, Ali Purnima here, yeah. I thought we should take this opportunity for Sonal to quickly mention about this fabulous program of unschooling.
Go ahead. Yes.
Yes, about unschooling, it's a program which emerged out of the present situation of pandemic where, children were bored sitting in front of the screen and learning and losing interest, which otherwise they were doing it before the pandemic. So we started this program with an intention to help children to create interest in their learning. Along with that, enjoy the process which doesn't involve screen. So we are doing activities which doesn't involve screen and which includes life skills. So self-awareness is growing. They are learning how to deal with certain aspects. And all this could happen because we were applying what is being taught in certificate in child and adolescent. So that's how it is complementing for people who have done the course to deal with children in any kind of situation, may it be pandemic, may it be regular, whatever it is. But children are ready to learn, and how much we can give is something left to us. And that is what is done in unschooling. And we are enjoying learning along with them, I can say.
Yeah, true, true. Thank you, Ali. Over to Seema and Ali.
Okay. I am not anti-technology, but I enjoy how technology sometimes takes over from what we do. Divya wanted to ask, where do I start if I want to learn about counseling and therapies? And she wanted to write DCS, IPCG, and PGDP. You know what her phone did? It converted IPCG into ITCH. Itch. So that's how I am very, very particular. Technology can be a wonderful slave, but a horrible master. We always keep that in mind in whatever we are doing. Let us not lose that human touch when we are interacting with people, when we are learning, when we are growing, when we are building relationships and things of that sort. Yes.
Yes, Ali. Gauri wants to know, so which course will help me to become a child counselor?
Yeah. See, a child is not an independent entity, Gauri, as you know. A child is very heavily dependent on all the adults around him or her, starting with the parents, then if there are grandparents around, if there is a domestic help like a maid servant around, then the teacher, right from the play school teacher going on to all the other teachers. So a child's life is continuously controlled by the adults who are the important people. So when you want to be a child counselor, you should also be an adult counselor. If you do not understand the mind of an adult who controls the child, you cannot individually work with the child. Ask any of the teachers who are very concerned about their students, who want to do. Many a time you'll hear them in frustration saying, this child has so much potential, I can work with the child, but I'm not getting cooperation from the parent, you know. The parent doesn't seem to be putting in the right effort, or sometimes the parent is negating what I'm saying, and therefore I'm not being able to work. So that is the importance. Let's say, you know, a child has a father who has become a confirmed alcoholic, addicted. Now you need to know what goes on in the mind of a person who has become an addict or an alcoholic, because that is the father is influencing the child. Similarly, you need to know about the victim. Let's say the mother is a victim of this, a codependent, as we call it. What goes on in her mind? Does she take out the frustration that she is feeling because of her husband's behavior on the child? We need to be aware of that, and we need to do something about that. So when you want to be a child counselor, our programs which teach counseling take you through that whole gamut. Along with that, that is the reason why we have the CCAD program, which helps you to understand every aspect of child behavior. Right from, in fact, we start from pregnancy, -9 months going on up to 18 years, where what goes on in the mind of a mother, what goes on in the development and growth of a fetus inside the mother's womb, going on to what happens to a child in the first 1 year of his life, the first few years of his life, and moving on. So once you understand what happens to a child and how the child grows, and you have learned the techniques of counseling from children to grandparents, then you know that, yes, now I can really help this child.
Right, Ali. So I think it will depend again from person to person. So Divya is asking, for clarity's sake, where should I start? Should I do counseling? Should I do therapies? Should I, you know, take up BCS or the other program?
Yeah. If you had asked a few days back, Divya, and if you happened to be in Bangalore, I would have definitely said that start with DCS. Let me still tell you, although today we are talking about the online courses, let me still tell you that my firm belief is that there's nothing to replace DCS. But for this year, we have closed the enrollments for DCS. So now it is up to you whether you would like to. Between the others, I would say you can take up IPCG or CCAD. I would prefer that you hold on for PGDP to next year if you have not had any exposure to counseling. But as Lakshmi told you a few minutes back, we do take in people for PGDP program who have not done their counseling. We have some extra sessions for them to familiarize them with the basic concepts of counseling so that they are not total strangers to it. And then we start teaching them the therapies along with the other students. So we are taking that into account in case you feel that, okay, let me not lose time. Let me start off with, let's say, the PGDP program, and I will enroll in June for DCS or whatever it is next year. So that we can discuss on a personal level.
Right, Ali. I think we're done with the questions, but one of the people who's consistently been writing to us is Garima. Hmm. And she says that thank you very, very much. Thank you, because you've gone online. So she's very happy. And yeah.
Our intention is that we do not want to force anybody. We know certain people have limitations. You have your loved ones. They are your top priority. After all, whatever we do it for the sake of our family members, our loved ones. No, they are our first priority, and we should not compromise their welfare or their safety under any circumstances. And that is the reason why we have taken so much time and effort. Initially, I told you that we were resistant to starting these online programs. But we said we are not going to deprive those people who, for genuine reasons, cannot do classroom program. Let their learning not stop. Let them also get something out of it, and let the thing go on. And more so because today, as I said, let us be very, very frank. We do not know when this thing will be over. Again, today's paper, I read that they want to start schools in December. But then they've been saying that from March onwards. It's very convenient that they just, when November comes, they say December, when December comes, they say January. And then the parents say that, no, there is no vaccine. I'm not going to send my child. Let that whole thing go on. So that is what the authorities will do, the experts will do. we will not question them. We will abide by whatever instructions and orders that are being given by the people who are responsible for the welfare of the citizens. But within that constraint, I end up with telling you what I told you in the beginning. They can control our bodies. They cannot control, or they rather, they should not control our minds. Our minds are 100% open, and we should not allow anybody to influence us. And least of all these statistics about COVID and the very morbid news that keeps coming in from morning to night, battering into people. Now, so many, up till now, we used to think that once you are through with COVID, you are happy. Now, so many people are talking about post-COVID things. After COVID, again, you fall sick, and then that happens. Anybody can fall sick. Anybody can have morbidity. Anybody can have anything. I may step out on the road after this program, and a lorry may come and knock me down. All that is part of life. Let us accept it as and when it happens. Right now, we are alive. We are healthy. Our minds are functional. Let us celebrate that and do the best that we can with our life.
Only Purnima here. I was just thinking that, you know, we should have I kept telling that we all work as a family and as a team. So I think we should have all of us on the screen and thank our viewers, and we'll be more than happy to answer that question.
Yes, yes. And after that, in 1 minute, our coordinator and wonderful leader of the team in many ways, Seema, will say bye-bye to you. Hold on for 1 minute after that. First, here is the entire team. You see Purnima and Sonal, and behind them, Sunita in one program. Sunita is not only our leading counselor, she is also the techie in our group. So if this program went without any technological hitch, you have to say thank you to Sunita. And Sonal, as I told you, is a person whom I'm very jealous of, because she gets to spend all her time with children, whereas we have to spend time with boring adults. Standing right behind me is Seema, who is going to end up in a minute. You've already met both Lakshmi and Chandra. They are both highly educated people. In fact, Lakshmi did her doctorate from the very prestigious National Institute of Advanced Studies, NIAS. Even Chandra has been very, very academically proficient, and she has been teaching, you know, right from postgraduate students to village teachers in their own mother tongue and in rural areas and all that. With that type of exposure, this team has come forward, and we are there for you. We want to include you in the Banjara family, and to do that, here is Seema for you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, everybody, Team Banjara. So,
thank you, Seema.
For all of you, we can, you know, just call us up, and you can write to us on Banjara Enquires, and we have different prospectus for our different programs, which has all the content related to that particular program, you know, along with the fee structure and, you know, different topics that will be covered. So we can send it out to you. Write to Banjara Enquires at gmail.com, and you can also write to us. You can text me my cell phone number, or you can call up Banjara Academy and text on our Banjara Academy WhatsApp number. So you can do all of that, and on a case-to-case basis we can suggest what that's why the first thing we ask is, what is your background and what is it that you are looking for? So according to that, we can definitely suggest. So thank you once again for joining us. And thanks again on behalf of Team Banjara. Have a good day.